surprised the jury would be able to separate from TV and real life. Look, we're strong enough without that kind of crap.
The cops framed his ass anyway.
Is that right, Byron?
No.
Come on. What's your theory?
Well, I think that cracker cop planted that glove, and they all did what they had to do to prove that OJ did it. That's what I think.
Okay. Here's the crime scene, Bundy. Here's OJ's house. Okay. Furman made up his mind at Bundy that Simpson did it, even though he had no idea if OJ had an ironclad alibi that would then ruin Furman's career and land him in jail. Furman takes the glove at Bundy, makes sure it has Goldman and Nicole's DNA on it, jumps in the car with the other detectives, heads to Rockingham with it, where he gets into the Bronco, somehow getting all that evidence in it, including Simpson's blood. Even though the police didn't have Simpson's blood until the next day. Then he goes over the wall, plants the glove behind Cato's room. Then, with the help of the rest of his super secret cabal of OJ-hating racist cops, he starts getting everything just so. Just where it needs to be. Nicole and Ron and OJ's blood into OJ's bedroom. OJ's blood back to Bundy. Oh, and OJ's Broncos fibers back to Bundy, too. Oh, and they don't forget to get rid of the real killer's blood from the back gate. No, no, no. And replace it with OJ's blood. Then OJ's sock. They get that back to Bundy to pick up all the blood and then get that sucker right back to Rockingham, too. These guys are a well-oiled conspiracy machine, after all.